Manager disrespects this mother with four kids. When she reveals her identity, he gets fired. In the bustling heart of the bank, under the unforgiving fluorescent lights, Gemma stands as an island of resolve amidst a sea of indifference. The bank manager, Alfred, towers over her, his voice a cold lash of contempt. "I'm sorry, Mrs. Taylor, but the bank cannot afford leniency with overdue loans," he declares, his words public and pointed, turning every head in the lobby towards her. Gemma's cheeks flush, not with shame, but with a rising tide of defiance. "I'm not just a late payment, Mr. Alfred. I'm a mother trying to keep her family afloat," she counters, her voice steady but her hands hidden from view, clenched tight. The room holds its breath, the air thick with tension and unspoken alliances. Alfred's smile is thin, devoid of warmth. "Personal circumstances cannot alter financial realities, Mrs. Taylor. Perhaps this will teach you to manage your affairs more prudently." His dismissal is a gavel's fall, echoing off the marble and glass. The crowd's gaze, a mix of pity and discomfort, follows Gemma as she retreats. Yet with each step, her spine straightens, her head lifts. This moment, raw and revealing, has ignited something within her, a fierce determination, a silent vow to rise above this degradation. As she passes through the bank's grand doors into the sunlight, Gemma's mind races. This ordeal has peeled back the veneer of civility, revealing the stark lines between those with power and those made to feel powerless. But Gemma is no mere victim of circumstance. She is a force of nature, tempered by struggle and bound by love to her children. Her resolve crystallizes with each step away from the bank, from Alfred's scornful domain. "This isn't the end," she whispers to herself, a promise hanging in the air. "It's just the beginning." Her journey, she knows, will be one of confrontation and revelation, a path that will lead her not just to vindication, but to a deeper understanding of herself and the silent battles fought by those who refuse to be broken. In the shadowed quiet of his expansive office, William Montgomery sits ensconced behind a desk that feels more like a fortress than a piece of furniture. Around him, the trappings of wealth and power whisper of success, yet they do little to fill the void left by a family lost. His heart, heavy with the weight of his wife's passing and the presumed death of his child, beats in a rhythm of solitude and regret. William has become a specter in his own empire, a man haunted by what-ifs and what-might-have-beens. Meanwhile, Gemma, a woman whose life is a testament to resilience and self-reliance, faces her own abyss, the mystery of her origins. It's a gap in her life that no amount of love for her children or determination can bridge. Fate, however, is about to weave its unpredictable patterns. A legal document, a last will and testament found among her late mother's belongings, becomes the unexpected catalyst. It's not just any paper, it's a confession, a posthumous whisper revealing that William Montgomery, the reclusive bank owner, is her biological father. The revelation comes at a time when Gemma's life is tangled in financial turmoil, her path inadvertently crossing with William's through the very institution he owns. The decision to reveal this truth now is born of desperation and a newfound hope. Gemma, confronted with the stark reality of her situation, sees in this revelation not just the answer to her lifelong questions about her identity, but possibly a lifeline in her current storm. As she steps into the cool, marbled expanse of William's office, the air between them is charged with the electricity of imminent revelation. She holds the document, a bridge between two worlds, her fingers trembling slightly, not from fear but from the weight of this moment. "Mr. Montgomery," Gemma begins, her voice stronger than she feels, "I believe there's something you need to see." The words hang between them, a key turning in a long locked door. For William, the sight of the document, the names and dates inscribed on it, is a jolt to his heart, a resurrection of hope from the ashes of his grief. The walls he built around himself, brick by brick, with each passing year of loss, begin to crumble at the revelation of Gemma's identity. In this moment, the complexities of identity and the unseen connections that bind us are laid bare. Gemma and William stand on the precipice of a new understanding, their lives intertwined by the fragile yet unbreakable threads of family. In the grand solemn expanse of William Montgomery's office, a space that has seen countless decisions shaping the fate of the empire he built, an unprecedented confrontation unfolds. Gemma, her spirit weathered by battles unseen and challenges untold, stands before him, not just as a petitioner, but as a mirror to his own long-buried grief and regret. The air between them is thick with anticipation, the silence before the storm. Gemma's revelation, the truth of her lineage, hangs in the balance, a confession poised to shatter decades of silence and solitude. "I'm your daughter," Gemma declares, her voice steady but her heart thundering against her ribs. The words cut through the air, sharp and irrevocable, leaving William reeling, his world tilting on its axis. The walls, adorned with achievements and accolades, suddenly seem inconsequential, dwarfed by the magnitude of this revelation. In the corner of the room, Alfred, the embodiment of the bank's ruthlessness, watches, his usual confidence wavering under the weight of the moment. The revelation of Gemma's true identity, coupled with the stark exposure of his own callousness, is a blow from which he cannot hide. William's decision is swift, propelled by a newfound clarity. "Alfred, your services are no longer required," he states, his voice resolute, not just severing ties with the manager, but also with a past that endorsed such cruelty. Alfred's departure is swift, a silent acknowledgement of the empire crumbling around him. Yet for Gemma, the victory tastes bitter. She watches Alfred leave, understanding that the wounds of her past, her struggles and humiliations, cannot be healed by his downfall alone. It's a realization that true healing, the mending of fractured bonds and the soothing of old scars, lies not in retribution, but in the arduous journey of forgiveness. As the door closes behind Alfred, Gemma and William are left in a silence that is both an end and a beginning. It's a moment fraught with the pain of what was lost and the tentative hope of what could be. The path to healing is laid bare before them, not just the healing of financial woes, but the healing of a father and daughter, estranged by fate but united by blood. This confrontation, charged with decades of unspoken emotions, marks the first faltering steps towards understanding and, perhaps, forgiveness. It's a journey that promises to be as complex as the emotions that have brought them to this precipice. In the dim light of early morning, Alfred sits alone in the modest confines of his apartment, a stark contrast to the opulence he once knew. Stripped of his position at the bank, he confronts the desolation of his choices, the silence around him a haunting echo of the life he's led. The man who once wielded power with a cold indifference now grapples with the shards of his shattered ego, each piece a reflection of his missteps and their consequences. Alfred's journey from denial to introspection is a solitary one, marked by long nights and the relentless question, "Where did I go wrong?" It's in these moments of vulnerability that he begins to see the outline of redemption, a path not paved with excuses, but with the hard truth of self-examination. His story challenges the notion that some people are beyond redemption, suggesting that even the most flawed characters can find their way back if they're willing to confront their past with honesty and courage. Meanwhile, Gemma navigates the complexities of her newfound relationship with William, her father. Each interaction is a tightrope walk between hope and hesitancy, their conversations a delicate dance around years of absence. This fragile bond, however, is a testament to the human capacity for forgiveness and the endless possibilities that lie in second chances. Gemma, with her resilience, becomes a beacon of hope, not just for herself, but for William, guiding him through his own transformation. His awakening to fatherhood, tentative and fraught with uncertainty, is nonetheless a step towards mending the deep fissures caused by years of neglect. The story of Alfred, Gemma, and William is a tapestry of human frailty and strength, weaving together the individual threads of their lives into a narrative rich with the potential for reconciliation. It suggests that healing is not a moment of sudden clarity, but a journey made up of small, brave steps towards understanding and acceptance. This narrative underscores the power of forgiveness, not as an act of forgetting, but as a means of freeing oneself from the chains of bitterness and resentment. From the intertwined journeys of Alfred, Gemma, and William, we learn the profound lesson that redemption and reconciliation are within reach for those brave enough to pursue them. This story beautifully illustrates that healing is a process, not a moment of epiphany, and it requires courage, introspection, and a willingness to forgive. It teaches us that the path to forgiveness is paved with understanding and acceptance, not just of others, but also of ourselves. Through their struggles and growth, we're reminded of the resilience of the human spirit and the transformative power of love and compassion. Moreover, the narrative highlights the importance of facing our past and our mistakes as crucial steps towards personal growth and healing. It showcases the beauty of second chances and the possibility of mending broken relationships, underscoring the idea that it's never too late to change and make amends. Reflecting on the story's themes of forgiveness and redemption, have you ever experienced a moment in your life where offering or accepting forgiveness led to personal growth or healing? How did this change your perspective on forgiveness and its impact on your life?